final contribution of this session, we go to L'Aquila with a presentation by Dr. Nagorny.
Good morning for everybody. My name is Sergei Nagorny. I'm from L'Aquila Science University in collaboration with the Gran Sasso Underground Laboratory. I will speak about the quenching factor in the zinc selenite synthetic bolometer. And so unfortunately, or fortunately, I will not speak and about the compound on which government spent billions of euro or dollars, or about the material on which everything goes well, like LUAP doped praseodymium. But I would like to turn your attention on the compound on which everything goes wrong, at least from my opinion. So when you listen or hear about the cesium zinc selenide, you can remind in your this material used for infrared application like a windows, or it's like a material for the X-ray or alpha particles detectors, or like light emitting of the diodes or diode lasers, or even very recently it started to develop as ultraviolet detectors. But I would like to, put your attention also on the very new application of these materials, like scintillating bolometers. What it is? What these detectors, how it is working, application we can, and result we can obtain with this material, with this detector. So how bolometric technique is works. If you will cool down very deeply your crystal, like cesium iodine, zinc selenite, or any other, even cesium iodine, sorry, I always remind. up to the temperature, down to the temperature 10 millikelvin, it's our, normal temperature on which we are working with the crystal. You will, all the contribution introduced by particles interacting with the crystal will convert to the heat, and only small part in the, probably in the light if your crystal is scintillating. So, and due to the fact that you have a very small, very tiny thermal heat capacitance, you will have a small and also very tiny pulse of the increasing of the temperature that you can detect with a very sophisticated detector like a natron transmuted germanium, which is sensitive and change the resistance and the temperature, and it will be about, like you can see, about few mega ohms per MeV change, and you can measure this change of the resistance. If you have a crystal that also can scintillate, and you put together to the, bulk crystal, small wafer of germanium that will absorb all the light emitted in this crystal, and also glue the NTD thermistor on this second bolometer, you can acquire your detector in a simultaneous way. It means one channel will be for the heat, another channel will be for the light, and you can drastically reduce your background, or increase your distinguishing possibility between several type of particles that interact with your crystal. And this such kind of crystal very suitable for some application with the low, with the elusive rate, like very low counting rate of the event. And first I raise the question, if zinc selenide work as a scintillating bolometer. So we made a test with a bulk crystal, 1,000 tests of the such kind of crystal, but I would like to represent one of the best one. So you can see that about 400 grams of the crystal was measured for about 1 month. It looked like crystal holded in the copper structure with a Teflon really S-shaped holder with the glued thermistor and heaters, and also covered by a light detector is a germanium wafer, also with the glued thermistor and heaters to thermalize at the same, the working temperature of the thermistor. It was acquired in the simultaneous way. And we typically plot our result in the way that scatter plot, like we have one channel on the axis, and on the X we pointed the energy detected, total energy of particle detected in our detector. And we and easily distinguish the particle, different type of particles that our detectors is register. For example, this is a beta and alphas. So for zinc selenide, it's some anomalous, let's say, and anormous behavior in comparison to the all other scintillators, because quenching factor, which we determine like light year for the alpha particles and light with the ratio, in ratio to the light yield for the gamma rays or beta particles, is more than one, more than one, and significantly sometimes can be more than one. So this is behavior was attractive for the experimentalist, and especially for the experimentalist in nuclear physics like me in rare events, rare decay searching. So, and one of the application of zinc selenide is looking for the application is a search for double beta decay of selenium 82. It's double beta decay is the rarest decay around the world, around the universe, which occurs with a half-life like more than 10 to 22, 20, 25, and still neutrinoless double beta decay is still not discovered and not detected. So, and some society of scientists looking for this process. And our group concentrated on zinc selenide as a detector, appropriate detector, to look for double beta decay of selenium 82, which decay with energy about 3 MeV. In zinc selenide, we can introduce about 56% of the selenium, so it's very high portion of the useful material inside our detector. So we previously our experiment was called like Lucifer, a low background underground cryogenic installation for Elisev rate, but recently, fortunately, because I do not like this name, we turn it on to the Cupid Zero. It's like in framework of the, probably you hear about the CoRE experiment in Gran Sasso, which operate with 1 ton of tellurium dioxide crystal, cool it down to the 10 microkelvin. For looking for the tellurium 130 double beta decay, it will be like update of this experiment with the new detector, with new nuclide. So, and we propose, our group propose to use zinc selenide as this material. So Cupid Zero, it will be a demonstrator array with enriched crystal, zinc selenide, 82 bolometers. Now we already produce 24 crystals of zinc selenide with a total mass of material, enriched material inside, 5.4 kilograms. And we expect the background rate about 0.001 count per keV per kilogram per year. So it's some crazy amount, some crazy, let's say, value, because, for example, to detect one event, we are expecting to wait several years of this ton experiment. So, enriched zinc selenide crystal. So, in a simple case, from the bull, which you take out from the growing facility, you should cut it from the nose part, tail part, and made a rounding to produce such shiny and kind and very very fancy crystal. But obviously, nothing is very easy in our life, at least from my opinion. On each step of the production, it appears some problems. In our case, it's a cracks in the crystal. And we try to, since it was on the way of the production of enriched crystal, we would like to solve this problem as soon as possible. And the simplest way how we can, how our colleagues from from the ISMA try to solve this problem, it's a thermal treatment. So we are using several samples of the crystal, two of the samples produced from our zinc selenide powder that was produced in the similar way as an enriched powder. And last crystal was produced from the CVD material. It was very easy scheme of thermal treatment. We just put the crystal in the quartz tube, put in the vertical oven, pumping to the vacuum, put a little bit of argon to achieve about 1 atmosphere in the working point, warm up to 900 degree and stay 1 day at this temperature and slowly cool down. So, but unfortunately we observed some unexpected result and for us. So for all crystal, we reduce the value of the amplitude of the signal, both from the heat and from the light detector. For this crystal, you see it's rather drastically, 3 times we reduce this amplitude. We also see that the pulse, thermal pulse in our crystal become more slower as well as on the rise time, as well on the slower decay component, and also appear some, as was called in the previous presentation, delayed or very slow component of the decay. Also, we measure some resistance of the of this crystal, and we see that, for example, for Sergei, that before was very, very high ohmic, we see the reduction of the resistivity, means our crystal become more conductive. So, and how is changing from our experimental point of view the behavior of the crystal? Probably you remember this plot before. It was alpha, it's a smeared alpha source, it's an internal alpha background, this calibration betas. So we can easily distinguish this to the population, just cut in such way. After thermal treatment, we see that we invert betas become more higher light yield, alpha become less light yield, and this almost vanishing the distinguish between two types of the particles. And we see the also the reduction for the light yield for the gammas and more drastically for the alpha particle, which very crucial for our experiment. We also see the change of the transmittance spectra in the visible range and also in the infrared range. We obtain the same result for the three different crystals. Also significant reduction, as well as for the third one, even more drastical. So just in this table, I would like to summarize a little bit what we obtained from our point of view. We see that light yield, except for sample number one, where it's increased, it's decreased. More drastic decreasing for the alpha particle, about 14 times for zinc selenide producing from CVD powder doped with aluminum. We have a change of the transmittance spectra in all the region where we measure it. So what I can say it's as a summary. So for as grown crystal, zinc selenide always have a we obtain that have a quenching factor for alpha particle more than one. It means that light yield for the alpha more. Sometimes even significantly in comparison to the light yield for the gamma particles, gamma quantum. Highest light yield in our crystal is correlated with the doping by aluminum on the level about 100 ppm. And the, as grown crystal, we have faster heat signal and we have pulse-shaped discrimination both on the heat channel, means on the signal from the heat channel from the phonons and also from the light channel. And we have a crystal with a high resistivity, let's say a high ohmic crystal, more than 10 to the 10 ohm to multiply to meter. While in the contrary, after such kind of thermal treatment, we invert the quenching factor for alpha particle. We significantly decrease signal amplitude for the both signal, light and heat. We decrease the light yield. We deteriorate the energy resolution. And we slow down our signal in also in both channel. And we do not obtain anymore the pulse-shaped discrimination, and we also get the crystal with a low resistivity. But at the end, it can be the way how to produce a sandwich-like crystal if just from zinc selenide, which can be sensitive as well for the alpha particle like a first layer, as well also for the gammas in the second layer with the quenching factor more sensitive for the gammas. So as a next step, we would like to make some TSL measurement on the TSL with a thermal treated and as grown crystal. As well, we would like to measure the emission spectra of this sample and try to probably compare our result with the measurement on zinc selenide produced by PVD method. And I would like to thank you for your attention, and I would like to attract you to help us to solve this puzzle of the anomalous quenching factor. Thank you.
Thank you. Are there any questions? Realizing that the questions are Just before the lunch.
Of course.
You had a band from CO, is it correct? From carbon oxygen molecules.
Yes, because in our material we cannot avoid some contact with the air during the production.
Yes.
So and always happens that we have some oxygen. In our case with off production enriched crystal, we would like to eliminate as much as possible the oxygen. Let's say contact with zinc selenide powder.
But you have also carbon.
Carbon is due to the fact that we grow our crystal in the graphite crucible.
So you have to remove these things from.
We try also grow the crystal in glassy graphite. It means with the material with let's say less evaporate.
I know what you mean.
But we do not have a better result.
I see.
And you know the most important in case when you deal with the enriched material. It's to find the optimum between the losses, between the quality of the material that you get and the price of the material that you use for to get your detector.
With respect to that, did you try annealing in a selenium atmosphere?
No, because after this encouraging result, we would like to stop the thermal treatment and just to use as grown crystal to save our material.
Okay, here we can conclude this session, so let's thank our last speaker again and all the speakers of this session.